गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, नमस्कार दोस्तों। आज हम जानकारी लेंगे सोसाइटी में जो अनेकविध रिकॉर्ड्स रखे जाते हैं वो कितने समय तक सोसाइटी ने मेंटेन करना है उसके बारे में। वी विल हैव ए लुक एट द डिफरेंट रिकॉर्ड्स विच ए सोसाइटी हैज टू मेंटेन एंड फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग द सोसाइटी हैज टू मेंटेन दोज रिकॉर्ड्स, दैट वी विल डिस्कस टूडे। फ्रेंड्स, सिंस इंसेप्शन ऑफ ए सोसाइटी वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स आर generated in a housing society. Some records belong to members, some records belong to the society day-to-day affairs, some records belong to the correspondence between the municipal corporation, their circulars, their orders. Some records belong to the deputy registrar's office, orders received from the deputy registrar's office, directives received from the deputy registrar's office. Some records belong to the banks, the day-to-day transactions with the banks, the bank reconciliation statements, the passbooks, the checkbooks, the counterfoils of the checkbooks. Various types of records are generated in a housing society. The share certificates given to members, their copies, the members' individual files. All these records can be divided into three parts. One is temporary records, mostly pertaining to the day-to-day correspondence done by the secretary on a regular basis. Then there are certain records which have to be kept mandatorily for a period, a limited period of 5 years or 10 years. And then there are certain very important documents which have to be preserved by society permanently. Step by step, we shall have a look at all these records today. Friends, a housing society is a very dynamic situation wherein all members are equal and nobody is important or nobody is indispensable, and hence it is very imperative that the society office bearers who change time to time maintain continuity amongst themselves and preserve all the records as per the norms laid down by the law safely and soundly. Every society maintains a cash book recording all the financial transactions of the society. This cash book has to be maintained by the society on a permanent basis. Then there is a shares registers of members and a members' ledger which is generated every year. These two documents have to be maintained by the society on a permanent basis. The I and J register of members has to be maintained, updated and kept on a permanent basis by the society. Then there are minutes of the general body or minutes of the managing committee of the society. The minutes book of the general body and the managing committee are documents which are to be preserved by the society on a permanent basis. Then there is a property register of the society detailing all things about the property of the society. This register has to be preserved on a permanent basis by the society. Then audit reports given by the statutory auditors or the internal auditor every year are to be preserved and maintained by the society permanent basis. The title deeds of the society, the registration certificate given by the registrar's office, and then the standing instructions generated from the society for its members. These three are also very important documents and they have to be preserved and maintained by the society on a permanent basis. Then the share certificates issued to members, the counterfoils of such share certificates have to be preserved and maintained by the society on a permanent basis. Then the correspondence of the society with the municipal corporation or the deputy registrar office, all files pertaining to this correspondence have to be preserved and maintained by the society on a permanent basis. All vouchers pertaining to payments made by the society have to be preserved and maintained by the society for their records on a permanent basis. Then various contracts entered by the society or agreements entered by the society from time to time for maintenance of the buildings and upkeep of the society have to be preserved and maintained on a permanent basis by the society. All insurance policies have to be kept properly, safely and preserved permanently by the society. All plans and estimates and drawings of the society buildings have to be properly kept and maintained by the society on a permanent basis. All approved plans of the corporation and all correspondence pertaining to the conveyance deed of the society has to be preserved properly by the society and kept permanently. There are certain records, like temporary records and records which are kept for a certain period, which can be disposed of by the society after that particular period is over. How to dispose of these records? The managing committee has to sit together. They have to sort out all these records, verify all the records to be disposed of, so that records which are to be preserved permanently, mistakenly also don't go into that category, and then take a decision in the managing committee together, listing out what all documents they are going to dispose of or destroy, and then after a resolution is passed by the managing committee, signed by all the members of the managing committee, such records which are of temporary or a time-bound nature can be disposed of by that particular society. So much for today. You can see the presentation which follows my talk to have and record all the details about preserving records of by managing committee and the Cooperative Housing Society. Thank you.